the Packers. Yes, sir.
Just a disclaimer in this video. There is very bad language, and there is cannabis consumption in this video. So if you have little kids or something, it would be wise to let them watch this. This will probably be one of the few videos that I actually let go through. So if you're not into foul language or cannabis consumption, do not watch this. And no, I do not consume it. It is my brother slash best friend that's doing it in this video, and I have no problem with him with what he does, but I just wanted to give fair warning to anybody who's watching this. If you do not want to watch it, you might want to turn the video off now. Thank you. Alright, do you feel better?
It's like I have a nipple on my head.
You know it is recording now, right?
Is it really?
Yeah. That's definitely going in. Alright. Everybody, welcome. I'm Puddin', of course. And this is my best friend slash brother. This is Kevin, a.k.a. Peanut Butter. Glad to have you here. So, I wanted to kind of bring this. I know everybody does interviews with people, but I kind of wanted to do one with Kevin. Like I said, Kevin's my best friend slash brother. Me and him, I've had a lot of people that we've taken pictures together, and everybody says we look like brothers side by side. Well, now we both have the frickin' beard. We're getting closer. Well, you know, if you had glasses on. But it's still... Okay. He forgot something already. Oh, he has glasses.
I can't see the screen with these on because these are my reading glasses.
Oh,
but.
Okay, now look. Holy crap. Okay.
No, I can't see that. I'm going to have to look at that
fine.
Later on.
That's fine. Okay, so what I wanted to kind of get, some of my viewers want to know why you got into this life and, you know, what you drive, how you're living this life. So, if you can, if you don't mind, when I met you last year, you weren't in what you're in now.
No.
Can you kind of explain what you were in last year?
I was in a cargo van.
Well, you were in a cargo trailer.
A cargo trailer. Van, trailer, they're all about the same size. But yeah, so I was in an 8 or 10 by 12 cargo trailer.
Now, why did you choose that at the time?
Because I just wanted to get the fuck out. I didn't care about being comfortable.
I don't know what happened. My phone just shut off, so we started back up.
I thought I could pack a bowl in the time it took him to get everything started up again.
Yeah.
So y'all didn't see this, but I guess you're all going to see it.
I'm friends with everybody. You know, like I said, gay, lesbian, transgender, pot smokers.
Hippies.
Or hippies, whatever you want to call them. I'm friends with everybody. And like I said, this man right here is close to being my brother. And I don't care what he does. I don't have to do it, and I don't like it. But they do it, you know, and my wife does it too. And that's fine. I have no problem
with
that.
And believe me, him and I disagree on all kinds of shit. But
we're still tight as brothers.
Yeah.
Literally.
We don't let that come between us.
Political...
Religious.
The only thing
we... A lot of things.
Yeah. The only thing we've never really argued about is money.
Because we're both broke, so...
That's
nothing,
true.
Nothing to argue about.
That's true. So, anyway, so you wanted to get out, like, really fast last year. And now, why did you want to get out?
Because I had been watching videos for, I don't know, probably a year previous, you know, watching all the usual suspects, you know, all that stuff.
Right.
And I just wanted to go, and I got to a point where I was so miserable in what I was doing in my day-to-day routine that I decided that it would be better to get out there and just wing it with what I had and be a little uncomfortable than to sit there and be miserable another day. And
right.
So that's what I did. I just packed up my shit and I went, and fortunately, it worked out.
Yes, it did. Now,
a lot of people are going to be like, okay, how can you guys be as close as brothers and you guys have any, well, we've known you, not even a year yet. It would be RTR. January would be a year. People, I bet you anything, people are like, how in the hell can you two be brothers or act like brothers or be that close as brothers with not knowing each other? What would your response be then?
The world works in mysterious ways. You just...
Because, well, when we met each other...
You just never know.
I mean, I was just walking around and...
You got a Facebook notification.
We're not... we don't care about no Facebook notifications. When I...
See, that's the kind of thing we...
Yeah, and he does that shit all the time. So, I mean, but when I first met you... We had just started talking. I mean, it was just out of the blue.
You were having trouble with your trailer. You couldn't get your trailer off because your jack, your electric jack, was having issues, and you didn't have the part that you needed to make that connection. I just happened to have that part.
Oh, that's right.
I just happened to have that part.
And we started talking.
Oh my God, the stoner's memory works.
Yeah, but the first time you actually came out of his trailer and met him, he was carrying, you got to picture this, a 4-pound tub of peanut butter with a spoon in it. That's exactly what he was eating the day I met him. I mean, a four-pound tub with a spoon and just eating it like it was cereal or something.
Hence the name peanut butter.
Hence the name. And that's why we call
it... From that day forward.
And now it's called peanut butter pudding time. So it's not no peanut butter jelly. We want peanut butter pudding. What made you decide to go from the cargo trailer to what you're in now? And if you would, explain to people what you have.
Well, I've been through a few different vehicles. So after the cargo trailer, I came back for and hung out for a while last winter in just the F-250 I was driving. And I was just sleeping in the back of that. And then I got my summer work camping job, and I was able to acquire a 35-foot fifth wheel, which was perfect for the job. After dragging it 700 miles from where I was in California out to Phoenix, I decided the fifth wheel wasn't quite what I was looking for. They're big. You fifth wheelers out there, you're a very special breed. Good on you. I just can't handle those big fucking things. And I was a truck driver, and I... Yeah. But now I'm in this...
It's a 1997?
It's a 97 Econoline 150 van conversion.
And it's called a Universal.
The Universal van conversion. I would let y'all look inside, but it's kind of trash right now. Maybe someday when I finally get the interior built out the way I want to, we'll do a little tour of the van, but until then...
Oh, and another thing, this is off the subject... We were at a rest area as we were on our way here. We had just stopped and got Kevin in Phoenix or in Goodyear. And then we were on our way there. I don't want it on me. This is about you.
Yeah, it's all about both of us.
You're such an ass. So anyway, this guy in a semi stops and gives us a box, a crate of Danimals yogurt. We get here and we all three, me, my wife, and him... had the Danimals, and that night we all had
Danimal shits.
We had the Danimal screaming shits. And I was just looking over, you have them all in the trash bag.
All in my trash bag.
And then I didn't realize it was the Danimals until last night.
He went and shot his up today.
And I went and ate one last night, and I was had this gut-wrenching pain. And I was on the toilet pretty much all the night, and I did not like it. And I was like, it's got to be those. I think they're bad or whatever. So I just saw those anyway.
And in the near future, we will be teaching you how to shit in the desert.
Oh, yeah. We got a video coming out where me and him are going to... It's going to be a... I'm not going to give it all away, but it's going to be kind of comical. So I hope you guys enjoy this.
It's
going
to have to be.
Oh, it's going to be all comical.
It's going to have to be, man.
Just look for the... shitting in the desert video when it comes up.
It might be a while because he's dealing with a stoner here, so. And where the fuck is my pipe? There it is.
Oh, you had something over on this side.
I got it everywhere. It's all over the place.
So, and I probably put in the disclaimer to begin with, there is cussing and marijuana usage in this video.
There is, because I can't help myself.
I don't care.
Good right now. I'm using the pipe and not the bong, but
I don't care what he does. He's still my brother. I don't like the stuff. I don't do it, but like I said, he does it, and it doesn't bother me. I don't care.
He turns it down.
I don't like it.
Every single time. So, excuse me while I cough up a lung.
So what got you into this life?
Why
did you make a sudden change where you're like, hey, I just want to go live free and I don't want to do the sticks and bricks or 9-to-5 anymore? What made you decide to live this life?
I think I was always going this direction. Ever since I was kind of young, I always was fascinated. My grandparents traveled in an RV every summer when we were kids. And, I always dug that. I always thought that was really cool, and I thought that'd be a cool way to live. I just don't fit into society too well. I like being around people and all, but I just don't fit in well with society and how society works. And this is just better. It's just better for me.
Needless to say, that's why a lot of us are out here.
And yes, you will hear a very similar story from a lot of full-timers that are doing this lifestyle.
But they don't fit into the sticks and brick or 9-to-5.
Or society in general.
Or society in general.
Some of us, truth be told, some of us have a kind of not the greatest outlook on society in general.
And it's not that we have bad backgrounds. It's just we understand how society wants us to be, and we're going to go against the grain. Yeah. Because we want to live life the way we want to live it, not how everybody else says we should live it.
Yeah.
So,
we look for alternative ways to make money legally.
Yeah.
We don't want to have a real job. I don't want to have a real job. So I look for ways to, take little side jobs here and there to do what I can to pay the bills, and a lot of us do that.
Yeah, a lot of them only work, 3 or 4 months out of the year, and they make enough money to survive for the rest of the year that they can live off of.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you have a lot of people going up to, South Dakota. They do the sugar beet harvest.
They do the sugar beet harvest up there.
A lot of people do...
this time
you
of
actually
year.
Went last year and did the camp hosting.
I did the camp hosting last summer, up near Yosemite. That was really nice. That was a fun job, better than working for a living, that's for sure.
The only thing is, he doesn't like doing the computer stuff.
I'm more of a maintenance guy. I would rather work on the maintenance side of
things.
He's
more hands-on like I am.
And not deal with the public, and not have to deal with money, and not have to deal with the office side of things. I've never done
that. Hi, how are you today? Thank you for showing up. that's the same. Yeah. I just can't picture you doing that a lot.
Yeah, that was definitely one of my weak points on that job was my I don't know. I'm an introvert, sort of. Yeah. Extroverted introvert.
All right, now you just screwed me.
What is an extroverted introvert?
That is an extroverted introvert.
An extroverted introvert is someone who likes being around people, but when I'm done, I'm done. And I'll just leave, and I won't say a word. I'll just quietly exit the scene, and I will look for solitude. And I can keep myself cooped up for a couple of days if I've had too much stimulation in a large crowd. So, concerts, Disneyland, places like that, which I love to do. After events like that, I usually will find a couple of days where I can have some total seclusion from the world. And that is what an extroverted introvert is.
And just a side note, I don't do crowds. I've had my issues with crowds in the past, and that's why I don't do them.
So he says, but someday you'll be seeing a video from Disneyland.
Yeah, they're trying to talk me into going to Disneyland and all that stuff, and I don't know if I'm ready to...
He can do it. I'll be his support crew. We can do it.
He's going to be my shoulder to cry on.
You watch, man. I turn into a 4-year-old.
Oh, dear God. now I'm going to have to babysit you?
I go to that place and I turn into a fucking four-year-old and I just...
So am I going to have to babysit you?
No, no.
Kevin, no, 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 don't touch that.
Oh, no, it's okay. I...
So...
The 45-year-old is still there, but I let the four-year-old take over.
So where do you see yourself and say... Or what rate do you see yourself in and where do you find yourself in, say, let's say 10 years?
10 years? Probably still out here on the road. 10 years, that'd put me at...
55?
55, yeah. Yeah, I can't add 10 very quickly. Did you see that? I just don't want to...
Too much pot. Brain cells move a lot slower.
That's right. He's absolutely right. 10 years? Man, I can hardly see tomorrow, let alone 10 years.
I know. But I just like asking because... people have asked me, like, where do you see yourself in 5 or 10 years? I see myself still doing this, but I see myself with a little bit bigger of a rig and just enjoying life.
I see myself definitely living this lifestyle because I don't think I could go back to the normal, what most people consider a normal lifestyle.
But like, see, this is normal for us.
It is normal for us.
And this is what makes us happy.
And every time I go back to visit my parents or something and I stay for a couple of days in their house, after a couple of days I'm ready to go because of, you know, I don't watch TV, I don't see the stuff that most people see in it. Yeah, no, just not into it.
Yeah,
not into it at all.
I noticed when I was parked at my aunt's house that I was on social media a lot and I hated it. Since I've been out here, I've hardly been on it. And it's wonderful because you get disconnected from the world and you actually get back with nature.
I'm still on it all the time. I'm still on it all the time. It's just the difference is now instead of posting stuff that I posted before that would be a little more edgy or, you know, stuff to intentionally make people...
Now it's more like
make people cringe. It's pictures of the sunsets. It's places that I'm at. It's
our friends we're with.
You know, it's donkeys up in Oatman, Arizona, you know. And
should we tell them the story?
Which story?
Cabot, get away from that donkey. Okay, last year, where we're camped out, we were probably 7 miles down the dirt road. And it was me, my buddy Ty, our buddy Ty, and Cabot.
Hi, Ty.
And there's a couple other ones that was with us. Ren was with us. And I don't remember... And
Butterfly was there. Mike was there.
Butterfly, Mike, and I don't remember that Ty's friend that was in that one rig. He was in the older, like, Bounder. Remember the Class A? He took off on his bike one day. And
oh, what the hell was that guy's name?
I don't remember. Anyway.
Jen was there. Hi, Jen.
Jen was there. Hi, Jen. So, anyway, that night, it was dark out, and all we heard was, and Kevin was out in the middle of the desert. And I'm like,
I wasn't out in the middle of the desert.
Yes, he
was. I
was
getting something out of my truck.
No, he wasn't.
Bullshit. I was getting something out of my truck.
He was out in the desert trying to play with the donkeys. I don't care what he says. He was out doing it. Because when he left, not even 10 minutes later, we heard the donkeys like, like, Kevin, get away from that. Or what do you know? Yeah, get away from that donkey.
You said, and I quote, quit fucking that donkey.
Oh, okay.
And my response was, mind your fucking business.
See? And then you think, I'm the one kidding? He was the one out doing it to the donkey, not me.
I was getting something out of my truck.
He can tell you that until he's blue in the face and it's not happening because we all know what he did with the donkey. Why would the donkey start screaming when you were over there with it?
Because we heard that shit every fucking night.
And then what happened? We go look for him, and you could never find him.
Nope.
Every time.
I must have hiked 2 miles up a damn wash an hour after they passed, and I couldn't catch him.
Well, and we took Ty's quad that one time. I did. I got on Ty's quad because I heard him going off. So we took up off the mountain and never saw one of them.
Mm-hmm.
Hear him, but you never saw one of them.
I saw him at about 5 o'clock in the morning when I got him, when I caught him walking up the road, and I got him with my light. But that was it. So it was like 200 yards away.
Oh, by the way,
I see him in my light.
Just so you know, we are actually known as the Wabam Brothers. We are the ones, actually, Aja, a pandemonium, started shining us with these bright lights. Have you got yours handy? I suppose you don't, do you? So anyway, I got a 700 lumen light. He's got a 700 lumen light. Is it 7?
Ba-bam!
You missed. So, is your 700...
But that's what the game is all about. Ba-bam!
Yeah.
So... I'm not sure what it is. I think it's at least 7. I think it's brighter than yours, so...
Oh, yeah, but yours is also newer than mine, too.
Excuses are like assholes, buddy.
Everyone's got one. They just smell a little different. So, anyway, I got one last year.
I can cite you.
Oh, dear God.
It looks like goalposts.
So, anyway, when it gets dark out, we sit and shine each other in the face. Like, we see who can get each other that bad. Aja started it. And then me and him have just got it going, and now we call it Wabam. And that's because that's all we say is Wabam. Last year, he had this little pin light.
And thing I lost
couldn't,
it.
Couldn't have been no more than this big. Thing. And I would get my big light out and get him, and then he would get his little itty bitty light and go, Wabam.
Wabam.
Freaking hilarious. But
he would piss himself every time.
Oh, it was.
It was fun for me to just go, Wabam.
It was just comical the way he did it. So anyway, the first night out here...
You had to be there, I know.
Well, the first night out here, I got him. I got him before he got me, so I struck first. But, in saying that, he's got me a couple times since then, too. So
I've gotten better at the game.
Night before last.
I got you good.
No, but I got you good right before you left. Because you were trying to do something with your hoodie, and I shined it up like this, and you're like, "Oh, you son of a bitch!"
Yeah, that's right. Block that out of my memory.
You were cussing me like a dog. And then I was like, "You need light to see to get home."
But before that, you came out of your rig. You opened your door, mm-hmm. and I was holding the light ready for you to open the door.
Yep.
See, we do that shit. We'll actually sit there and hold it ready from the walk around the corner, just to get that good shot.
So if you come out here and meet us and you start hearing wabam in the middle of the night, and that's all it is wabam, you know that people are trying to shine lights in each other's faces.
To blind each other with super bright lights.
Yeah.
There's no two ways to say it.
It's just hilarious. To us, it's fun. To some of you guys, you might think it's stupid.
It may be childish and dumb, but you know what?
It's
childish and dumb.
Yeah, it is. But it's fun. It's a lot of fun. So anyway, I'm going to wrap this up for now. Kevin, I want to thank you. Really? Now my phone's going to smell like that crap.
Good.
God damn it.
My hat still looks like I got a fucking
nipple.
Little puffy right there, man.
So you got a little nipple on your
head?
Yeah. Now you just need a little baby to suck it. Oh, you need a girlfriend.
I probably do need a girlfriend.
The donkey will work.
Donkey.
Oh, donkey.
Come here, donkey.
So anyway, if you have any questions for Kevin or anything, let me know. I'll try to get this posted this evening.
Because I'm hard to get hold of.
And I don't even know what day today is. He actually has his own channel, and I'm going to probably put it right here. Is it Maverick Adventures or Maverick Adventure? Maverick's Adventure.
Maverick Adventure. It's just a Facebook page. I haven't really done anything with it. I guess I'm going to have
to
start.
Are you going to start a YouTube?
I'm still thinking about starting a YouTube. I'm not sure yet. You know, I got some ideas for a channel, but when I do, he'll let you know.
Yeah, I'll let you know.
When and if. I still got some ideas.
So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this. I know it's went on a little bit long, but and then we got cars running by here. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said, this is my brother. Normally, if you see him, you'll find me. Unless he's getting sick of people, and then he disappears for a couple days. Oh, and then I got hiccups. That was a burp. That one tasted like Doritos. Anyway, be kind to one another. Love one another. And live life to the fullest, because tomorrow's not promised. Anything you want to say to him as a farewell?
Think that pretty much covers it.
Normally he would say smoke more weed.
Well, I always, you know, I advocate that. Please, everybody, there would be more peace in this world if you just fucking smoke more pot. See you guys.
Have a good night. Y'all take care. God bless. I love y'all.
Night country road, take me home. Take me to the place where I was born. Night back country road, take me home, back to the place where I come from.